روش دبای می مر
Praise the Lord. Glory. Come on in, everybody. Come on in, everybody. Everybody, come on in. All my School of the Supernatural students, let somebody know that we own. We own and popping, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Invite your followers. Invite your friends. Share this to your wall. I'm not going to be long with you. Hallelujah. I want to start sharing when we get to at least... Need to at least get to about 100 people or more. Share this to everybody. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, take over. Marashudobo moroshu. Mi mama marashudabe. He mi rabahashudabai mi mi robohu. Invite your friends, invite your followers. All supernatural students, let somebody in the school know that we're on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. How y'all doing out there? Hallelujah. Tonight is going to be good. I'm going to talk about a subject that most people, y'all probably know about, but there's rarely a teaching on this. And again, I'm going to say some things that might mess with your theology. However, it's going to definitely change your mindset and definitely make you aware of what's the true essence of the gifts of the Spirit of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Can y'all hear me? Everything good in Hollywood? Invite your followers. Invite your friends. Invite your haters. Invite all your elevators. Amen. Hallelujah. Today I want to talk about something that's very powerful. How you doing, Elva? Blessings. How y'all doing out there? All the supernatural students, please get on. Today I want y'all to make sure y'all share this. How you doing, woman of God? LaShawn. That's a great name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Today I want to talk about something that most people don't want to talk about. And I want to talk about the subject of gifts versus presence. Gifts versus presence. See, many people have gifts. There are many people who have gifts of the Holy Ghost. And some people have natural born gifts that they were born with. But today I want to talk about the Holy Ghost gifts versus the presence of God himself. And a lot of people don't know the difference between the two. And this is the reason why some people, how you doing, woman of God? Some people receive their blessings faster than others. Because many people are moving by gifts and not moving through presence. Amen. And so there's a big differentiation between the two, and we're going to talk about it. Let's, if you can, go to Luke chapter 5. Luke chapter 5, if you can, if you have your Bibles. If you don't, I will definitely read it for you in Luke chapter 5. So you're going to have to take my word for it if you don't have your Bible. Luke chapter 5. Hallelujah. I'm talking about gifts versus presence. Gifts versus God's presence. Look what Luke chapter 5 verse 16 said. And he, referring to Jesus, withdrew himself unto the wilderness and prayed. Look at verse 17. And it came to pass on a certain day, I'm reading from the King James Version, as he was teaching, that there were Pharisees and doctors of the law sitting by, which were come out of every town of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem, and the power of the law was present to heal them. The power of the Lord was present to heal them. Now, this always puzzled me, because the simple fact is, we all know that Jesus is the healer. Jesus, the person Jesus, is the healer. Amen. We also know that Jesus was filled with the Holy Ghost. We know that he was moved by the Spirit of God, and he was infilled with the Spirit of God. And when he did his fasting, he came out in the power of God. But you notice in verse 16, it says that, and he withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. Hallelujah. Now, even though Jesus was already performing miracles, he was already performing healings, already performing signs, wonders, and miracles, this time, the statement is saying that, basically, the scriptures are saying that, and when he was around all these guys, the doctors, the Pharisees, etc., that then the power of the Lord was present to heal them. See, there's a difference between a person moving in a gift versus moving in the presence of the gift giver. Amen. Many people prophesy because they have the gift of prophecy, but they don't move in the spirit of prophecy or have the presence of God for the spirit of prophecy. That makes a difference between whether your prophetic word goes quicker than another person would receive. So there's a difference between a gift versus the presence of God. Many people operate in gifts, but not many people operate in presence. Amen. What makes the difference between a person that's a gifted person versus a person that is a present holder or a present containment? Amen. It makes a big difference between the two. I've seen many people prophesy to people, give words of knowledge, but no brokenness, no weeping, no crying, no joy on a people's face. And the reason being why, because they were moving in the gifts, but they were not moving in the presence of the Lord. Amen. See, many people have a gift and they are unctioned by what the Holy Spirit gives. And see, there was no word for gift in the original text. It was mentioned about spirituals or spirits, or it was referring to manifestations of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So many people have to move through the unction of the Holy Ghost as he gives. Amen. But when you move in the presence of God, that means you and God himself become one entity. Oh, my God. When you move in the gifts, you have to wait for the unction of the Spirit to speak to you. But when you move in the presence, you and God become one, and he speaks on your behalf, or you speak on his behalf. Amen. It become an entwining between the vessel and the gifting. Amen. So there's a big difference between somebody just having a gift versus somebody who has presence. Amen. So the scriptures say that the presence of the Lord was there to heal them. Now, Jesus had been healing people. He had been laying hands on the sick. But see, the key was Jesus went back to the wilderness and prayed in verse 16. So it wasn't just the first 40-day fast that counted, but he had a continuation of consistent prayer and seeking the Lord for the fullness of his presence. Amen. So, yeah, please share this. Many people don't understand is that just because you have a gift, it can lay dormant if you don't take the seed. Now, let me tell you about this. You can have the gift of prophecy, but not have the spirit of the prophet. Amen. So what makes the difference is you can, when an unction or atmosphere come, anybody, even a donkey, a monkey, or a junkie, can prophesy. in the presence of God. Amen. When there's a presence there. Amen. But when you move in the spirit of the prophet, it's not just an office. And many of us address it as an office, which it is a form of an office, fivefold leadership, but it's really the person who operates or possessed by that spirit of the prophet or that office of the prophet. Amen. That's why the scriptures tells us in 1 Corinthians about that the spirit of the prophet is subject or submitted to the prophets. Amen. You can have the spirit of a prophet. I remember calling upon my spiritual father's spirit in a service one time, and I began to move, prophesy, act, talk just like him. Now, I had been prophesying. I've been walked in the office of the prophet, but I received a different level because I was connected to the spirit of the prophet. Only another officer can relate to another officer, or only another spirit can relate to another spirit. But see, when you have presence, it's different from a gift. See, a gift is something you have to wait to be given. Amen. You didn't work for it. You didn't do anything for it. It came to you as the Holy Spirit gave it to you. Amen. That's why many people, we all can prophesy, but that don't mean that you're a prophet. It just means that God has given you something at that moment time for you to speak on, for to address the body of Christ. But that's a gift. Amen. That's something that he gives you as he wills. But when you walk in the office or the spirit of the prophet, this is what takes place. You have the power to work it at any time, all the time, and you can give it to others. Because remember, you have when you walk in the office of a prophet or walk in the office of a spirit, what takes place is you have work to do. Because you're not going to be in the office without doing work. Amen. So an officer works miracles. An officer works the spirit of prophecy. He works at unctions in the spirit of prophecy. But that's a person who lays and labors in the presence of God. Amen. Any prophet that tell you, I just received this, you know, I got this anointing by grace. You know, it just came upon me. I was born a prophet. That's true. You can be born a prophet, but every office needs to be worked to be obtained. Every office needs to be worked to be obtained, because what you do in the office, you work in the office. Amen. So you have to work and graduate for you to receive the entitlement of an officer. It's just like in an army or a military. Anytime you become an officer, you have to move up in rank. You have to move up in spirit. You come in as a private. Amen. That means you have to spend your private time with the Lord. You have to learn to be disciplined. You have to learn to be a disciple. Before the disciples did great things in their office as apostles, they started off as disciples. They submitted as disciples. They were students. Amen. Then they graduated to friends, and from friends to sons, and then from sons to heir. Not every son will inherit God's kingdom. But we're talking about gifts versus presence. Amen. So many of you have a gift. Many of you have a gift, and God works through you from time to time in the gift of prophecy, maybe gift of healing, maybe different things. However, you don't have the presence of God to heal. This is the reason why one or two people may get healed, or one or two people may receive a prophetic word, but even then it don't come to pass. Because without the presence or accumulated over the gift, it still move in the dimension of the earth. Amen. But when you want to move it from the heavenly realm to the earth realm, and earth realm back to the heavenly realm, you need the unction to function, but you need it in the present type way. Now, the Holy Ghost moved by gifts. He moves by unctions. But when you're moving with the Father, the glory of the Lord, it backs you up. That means that the Spirit of the Lord pushes you. It's behind you. It moves you. Amen. There's certain times that I prophesy and the Holy Spirit didn't say that. I said it, and then God will back it up because I said it, because I have learned to be so much in the presence of God that me and him become entwined. This was the realm of the presence of God that Elijah moved in. He changed atmospheres. When you walk in the spirit of prophecy, or you walk in the spirit of healing, or you walk in the atmosphere of these giftings, the whole region changed. Even when you leave, you can impart. You know, you can impart people giftings. Yeah, because remember, a fivefold officer is also a gift, just like the Holy Spirit is a gift. Jesus left gifts unto men, which he means he left gifts unto mankind. Some he gave to be apostles, some he gave to be prophets, some he gave to be, etc. But many of you don't understand the presence of God. You're seeking the gift, but not seeking the presence. See, in the presence of God, there's fullness of joy. So that let me know right there, hallelujah. When you move in the presence of God, you don't have to worry about a present from God. When you move in the presence of God, you become one with God. He told Moses, I shall make you God over Pharaoh and make Aaron your prophet. So that lets you know Moses spent so much time in the presence of God that God made him a God. Oh my God. When it was time for Moses to speak something or to release something on the earth, he told him, you scratch forth your hands. I'm not going to do it. So many people are so afraid of not giving credit to God, and that's the reason why they cannot walk as God on the earth. Amen. You got to understand your oneness with God when you become in the presence of God. You're not seeking a present from God. Amen. I don't worry about a presence from the Holy Spirit or a gift from the Holy Spirit. I move with the Holy Spirit. I move with Father God. And that's the reason why I become the gift. Amen. I become the gift. I move in the gift because I become the gift. And that's the reason why I can impart the gift to others. Many of us walk in false humility because simple fact is like, you know, we give all glory to God, all praise to God. But remember, men even have glory. Jesus said, the same glory that he has given unto me, now I give it unto you. God wants us to have glory as well. But that does not negate from him getting any glory. It just means that we also have glory. You know, the Bible speaks about when Solomon in all his glory was in array as one of these. So some of us have to break the false humility spirit so we can walk in the presence of God. To walk in the presence of God, there must be a confidence. There must be a oneness with God. When you walk in the presence of God, there's no fear. You're not going to operate in fear. You're going to operate in pure faith. Supernatural faith, a faith that can raise the dead, faith that can heal the sick, and that you take no for an answer. Amen. That means heaven has invaded earth. That means even when you leave, certain trinkles and signs, we were just downstairs and we having a regular day, and an angel feather appeared on my daughter's leg. Amen. We didn't pray for it. We didn't ask, hey, Holy Spirit, could you send that? Could you give that gift? No, we walk in under open heaven to where heaven meets earth, that we constantly walking under Jacob's ladder, that we constantly have angels ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. You know, Jesus said something very powerful to one of his disciples when they said they saw him under the sycamore tree. He said, you know, why do you say I'm the Son of God? Because of what I said about seeing you under the sycamore tree? Basically, Jesus had gave one of his disciples a word of knowledge, which is a gift from the Holy Spirit. But he said, guess what? You'll see greater than these when you see angels ascend and descend upon the Son of Man. Basically, what Jesus was saying, don't get caught up in the gifts. Get caught up in the open heaven of my presence coming up and down upon you. Amen. When you begin to move with angelic hosts, when you just not waiting on an unction of the Spirit, or you got to wait for an atmosphere or a piano player to get you there, you walk with a presence. You come in with the presence of God. Amen. I know sometimes I prophesy and they don't have no piano player behind me, no drummer to rev me up, no piano player to have me this and that. I just walk in a place and the atmosphere shifts because simple fact is I am walking with God. There are many of you who are walking or working for God, but I work with God. God work with me. We work together. The Holy Spirit is my senior partner. The Holy Spirit is my co-worker. We work together to do the kingdom work of him who sent us. Amen. We be about our Father's business. Amen. We are co-laborers together. Amen. So when you understand your position in God, once you understand that it's all about the presence of God and not the presence of God, then you will operate in the presence. Amen. So this is what a lot of people keep on missing. You figure God way up there somewhere and you way down here, this minute being. And understand, it's not about making yourself high esteem. It's not making yourself bigger than what you are, but it's knowing your identity in God and understanding that his presence is everything to you. Amen. This is the reason why I don't really get upset about anything. Really, not too many things upset me, because simple fact is, in the presence of God, there's fullness of joy. So if you don't have fullness of joy, you haven't been in the presence of God. You may have a gift of God. God may even use you. You may even prophesy. You may even heal the sick. You may get a word from time to time, but you don't have a consistent flow of the Holy Spirit coming into your life. Amen. Because you lack the presence of God. Amen. The atmosphere in your home is different. You don't go places and nothing happens, because simple fact is, you walk in gifts, but you don't walk in presence. See, with a gift, you have to wait for the Holy Spirit to cut it on. But when you walk in his presence, you are on at all times. You connected and plugged in at all times in the Holy Ghost. Amen. So you don't have to wait on the unction of the Spirit. I can prophesy right now if I want to. I can pray for the sick right now if I want to. I don't have to wait for the unction of the Spirit. But the presence of God, it's on me. And see, Jesus recognized this in Luke chapter 5, verse 17, because he had been praying. He had went off into the wilderness and he knew that, hey, I sent something different than just the gift. Right now, I feel the presence of God is here to heal. Amen. Because he knew that he was walking under atmosphere. Okay, so to walk under atmosphere, you have to consistently be in the atmosphere. Oh, I'm going to say that again. To walk in the atmosphere, you must consistently be in his atmosphere. Amen. You got to consistently be in his presence for him to give you his presence. So if you want to see a change in you going from one level of the glory to another level of the glory, you got to understand God's power and placement in the spirit. You got to also understand the difference between just a person with a gift versus somebody with a presence. There are many prophets that are great prophets. They can prophesy. They have the unction of the spirit. But many people are not walking in this part of the prophetic. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 14:25, it says, and I'm just paraphrasing, when somebody come in and they get a prophetic word, they say this, and thus are the secrets of their heart be made manifest. So falling down on their face, they're going to worship God and report that the God is in you of the truth. Many people prophesy, but nobody's falling down on their face worshiping God and reporting that the God is in them of a truth. There's no brokenness. See, every prophetic word going to come with a sense of conviction and holiness. When it's a true presence from the Lord, a presence word, a word that was sent directly from God, not just a filter through a man, not just filtered from them trying to hear from the Holy Ghost, but when it's a true presence of God, when God says something by this time tomorrow, boom, it shall happen immediately. This is the reason why people are still waiting on their prophecies and waiting on things to come to pass, because they received a gift, a word of knowledge, or they received a prophetic word from God. But the thing was, there was no presence to push it and unction it into the now realm, or to unction it from the supernatural realm to the natural realm. Now, this is something I'm going to tell some of you. Many prophets and many apostles and leaders, they can give you a message from God, but they can't give you a manifestation from God. I'm going to say that again. There are many of them can hear from God and get the message, but they can't manifest it. And so you have to have the presence of God to manifest the message. Amen. John the Baptist had the message, but he didn't have the manifestations. The Bible said that John did no miracles. Amen. So you can be a messenger of God. You can say what thus said the Lord. Even John saw Jesus. He saw Father God. He saw the Holy Ghost, but he could not manifest that same glory. Amen. So you can be a prophet that can speak the word. You can probably even hear from God. You can probably even see God high and lifted up. But at the end of the day, you cannot get it to manifest in the earth realm. So you still need a Jesus to come in and manifest what you have saw. Amen. So not everybody, just because you have a John anointing, you making priests repentance, you making do this, but that don't mean that the presence of God is going to be there for salvation, or people are going to get healed or delivered. Because I've seen people preach the same message I preach and no manifestations. And I go there and then the whole house come down and people getting delivered, set free, saved, demons coming out and everything. Why? Because they had a gift, but they didn't have presence. The Bible said, you know, that the disciples, the apostles, they preached everywhere. And the Lord working with them, confirming the word that was preached with signs following. So they might, you might have a prolific preacher. He might be a great orator. He might be a great teacher. But if he don't have the presence following him, he don't have the realm of Father God. He may have the realm of the Holy Ghost. And he had to wait on unctions from the Holy Ghost. But when you walk in the realm of the Father, when you walk in the realm of the Holy, when you consistently one with the Father, nothing can stop you. You only do and see what the Father tell you to do. That's when you're moving in the presence of the Almighty. Amen. There's a difference between the Father's presence, Jesus' presence, and the Holy Ghost's presence. But that's another teaching. I'll talk about that another time. But you got to know the differentiation between all three. Amen. So many people, they feel the Holy Ghost. They feel chills. I used to joke with my wife all the time. People be talking about, oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. Yeah, because he's just passing you by. That's all. That don't mean you got the fullness of the Holy Ghost. He just passed you by. You just felt him pass by. Amen. That was just Jesus walk by you. But that don't mean you have the Holy Ghost in the fullness. I've seen people who not feel the Holy Ghost feel the Holy Ghost. And yeah, people in the world, when you say something prophetic to them, they be like, ooh, I felt that. I felt chills. Or their hair stand up. So just because you feel the Holy Ghost, that don't mean that you have the Holy Ghost. Just because you feel an unction, that don't mean you have the unction to function. So just because you feel something, that don't mean you have something. Amen. So it's not about your feeling. Amen. That's another sermon for another day. But many prophets, they're John. They can see God. They can hear God. They can recognize Jesus. They can do all these things, but they cannot manifest no miracles. Amen? So you not only need a John, but you need a Jesus-type prophet. You need a prophet that can see it, say it, and perform it. See it, say it, and demonstrate it. Amen? So many people, they're moving off of people that can give them a word. All y'all just want a word. You want a word. But you don't want a manifestation. You say you want a manifestation, but you word junkies. Oh, I want a word. I need a word. I need a confirmation. No, I need a manifestation. I don't need just a confirmation. I mean, confirmation means that, hey, I ain't catch it the first time. We need more than just a bunch of confirmations. We need more than just a bunch of prophetic words and words of knowledge. We need it manifest in the now. So people spend thousands of dollars and sowing thousands of dollars of seeds and no manifestation. And nothing wrong with that. Many people who have sold time ministry, and this is no boast or brag, soon as they sow, stuff start happening. Why? What's the difference between me and the other prophet? Not saying I'm the most accurate prophet. I know a lot of prophets are way more accurate than me. But the difference between me and them is I got presence. I have presence. So when I say something, I take it from the future and bring it into the now. It manifests instantly because of the presence that I'm walking under open heaven. I'm walking in the glory, not just the anointing. So that's what made the difference between some prophets versus other prophets. Amen. Some apostles versus other apostles. Some apostles never raised the dead before. Some apostles don't even do the Matthew chapter 10 anointing. I'm not going to even get into that. I'm going to let my son Apostle Black teach on that. But the point I'm making is this. You got to have more than just giftings. This is the reason why you need training and you need to be around people who walk in not just the gift, but the presence of God. They can make things happen in the earth realm. Because just because you get a message from God, that don't mean you can get a manifestation from God. I know that's why the Bible said that prophecies, they will fade. Look what it said. Look what it said in 1 Corinthians 13. And a lot of people miss that. But because guess what? You got a war for the prophecy. The reason why you got a war for it, because you got to get it into the earth realm through the presence of God. You need to open heaven for it to come into full fruition. And that's the reason why some people don't see their breakthrough or don't see their manifestation come to pass. It got to be presence seed. You know, he's a rewarder for those who diligently seek him, seek his presence, not his gifts. His gifts come once his presence is sought. His gifts come once his presence is sought. The Bible tells us, 1 Corinthians 13, it tells us, verse 8, charity, love never fails, but whether it be prophecies, they will fail. So this let us know that prophecies can fail. So don't jump down a prophet's throat when a prophecy fall. Several things took place. You as a recipient did something that did not, didn't have something to do with it, or either that prophet was false and he was listening in the flesh, in the realm of the flesh, not the realm of the spirit, or you did not walk for the prophecy that was given. So you can't get upset with the prophet. You can't get upset with these people of God. However, you got to discern what prophet has gift versus a prophet that has presence. Amen? So you got to discern this so you can know who to sow into. Was it presence there? Did I feel the Holy Ghost when he prophesied to me? Was it a presence in the atmosphere? So if all that is in play, he spoke it and it bear right in your spirit. Now the next thing is, it's off the prophet now. It's off of him now. Now it's up to you. Now you got to walk for it. Now you got to go and get in the presence to retrieve that present, because God is like this. I can tell you I sent you an email. But at the end of the day, you still got to go check. You got to go look up your email to get the mail. So just because I send you something, God's saying just because I send you something, you still got to go check your email to make sure it's in there. So you still got to go check it. You still got to go Google it or whatever you got to do. Go check, put your passcode in to go get it. So that's still a work ethic on your part as the recipient. But you got to know that there's presence. Amen. So stop falling. I'm not here to talk about any prophet. I love all prophets. Amen. Especially the real ones. And we praying for the false ones that they get saved and set free. And all witches, warlocks, I hope y'all get delivered as well. Use your gifts for the greater good of God and not those unclean spirits that you're operating in. Amen. But the point I'm trying to make here is this, people of God. You know, we get mad at the person who released the word. We get mad at the people who released the gifts and this and that. But you got to do your part as a recipient. Amen. You got to know the difference between if they were operating in just a gift or they were operating in the presence of God. Amen. You got to have Jesus and John. Amen. But another thing, you can't have a miracle and you can't have a manifestation without John's message. You want Jesus' miracles, but you got to have John's message to go with Jesus' miracle. Amen. Because remember, John's message came before the miracle came. So a lot of people want the miracle. Oh, prophet, pray for me. Everything good. Pray for this. Pray for that. Pray for my job. Pray for my child. Pray for my husband. Pray for this. But you don't want the message or the instruction that come with that. And sometimes it's not always a good word. John didn't always have a good word. John was saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So how do we get in the presence? Just like John said. First, let's repent. For the presence or the kingdom of God is at hand. Because God does not come in his presence without bringing his kingdom with him. So when you walk in the presence of God, you're walking in the kingdom of God. Because the two are entwined. So many people have the gift of God. But they do not have the presence of God. Amen. So you got to know the differentiation between the two. Amen. So that comes with the power of God. That comes with the fear of God. That comes with the presence of God. You need it all. So many of y'all, they so gifted. Ooh, that was powerful. You don't even know what real power is. I've been in service, people talking about, ooh, she was powerful. All she did was holler and scream. All he did was holler and scream, and you call that powerful. No change, no deliverance. No manifestation, no awe, no evidence of anything that God was there. There's a bunch of emotional people crying out or thinking about their problems. That's not the presence of God. That's an emotional fest. That is an emotional fest. No healing, no prophecy, nothing took place. Nobody got delivered. Nobody repented. No salvation. That was just a screen fest. That was just a hooping hollering screen fest. We got to learn the difference between true presence of God versus performance. True presence of God versus just an atmosphere of emotional people. True presence of God versus people that are gifted and can give you a few things of the Spirit, but there's no long-lasting impression. There's no long-lasting results are going on. This is the reason why people lose healings. Because they receive the healing through the gift realm and not the presence realm. Because the presence is going to remain as long as you stay in his presence. The presence is going to remain when you stay in the Father's presence. But when there's just gifting, it can come and go. You got to know the difference between the two. That's the reason why even Jesus himself said, guess what? Even if I hear you, go sin no more, lest something worse will come upon you. Go sin no more, lest something worse will come upon you. So even if Jesus himself come down and heal you, if you go and move yourself back to an atmosphere of doubt, no faith, living a sinful life, you can still lose your healing. Do that make Jesus false? Do that make Jesus not God? No. That means that you somewhere the recipient, you sinned. Somewhere you didn't stay in the presence. Somewhere you stopped seeking God to remain to keep your healing. So the same thing goes with prophecy. Just because God and some prophecies, they will fail. So, you know, if the scriptures tell us this, we got to know the difference, people of God. But we also got to know the difference between when we're receiving it from a person that's gifted versus somebody who has presence of God. Amen. When we left Hereford, Texas, they still flowing in the presence of God because we didn't just come with gifts. Yeah, gifts was there. It was powerful, whatever, as far as gifts. It was small. But the main thing that stood out the most was the presence of God. The presence of God was so heavy in that place. People were weeping and wailing and crying. And to this day, they still operating in the glory of God. They still moving in the miracles. Because they received the presence of God, not just a gifted person releasing the unctions of the gifts. You got to know the difference. You have to know the difference so that way you won't be upset at the prophet and stop believing in prophets, stop believing in Jesus, stop believing in God all in general. Because by you going around people, that some of y'all are under pastors that's just gifted but no presence. You know? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, prophet of state. It's true. Some of y'all are under pastors and leaders that just, they got a gift. They can sing real good. You know, they're a good preacher. But no presence. No presence of God whatsoever. They're only anointed at church. You catch them outside of church, they couldn't prophesy to a fly. They couldn't heal a dog from fleas with flea medicine. Amen. So you got to know the difference between a person that's gifted versus a person that has presence. Look at prophetess, y'all. She's trying to sneak up on me.
Blessings.
Prophesy. Talk to the people.
Deep aside.
Talk to the people. Deep
prophesy. Blessings to you guys.
See? You got to know the difference between the gifts versus the presence of God. So get around people that have the presence, not just people who have a gift. And that's the reason why y'all prophetic junkies, y'all hop from prophet to prophet to probably get a word. Because simple fact is, you haven't got around a person who have the presence. Or you don't have the presence yourself. That's the reason why you keep needing the word. Because the fact is, you haven't got in the presence as the recipient to pull that word to pass. Amen? So just because you pray and you fast, that don't mean you're in the presence.
Come on now.
You got to talk to God. You got to have an intimate relationship with God. It's more than just praying and fast. I know people who fast but don't pray. I know people who pray but don't fast. But they don't. You got to have a relationship with God. He got to be real to you as your spouse, as your children. You know how a child used to talk to a pretend friend and you have a hard out conversation with that friend, you need to talk to the Holy Ghost just like that. You need to talk to Father God just like that. Like when you was a little kid. That's why he said tell us to have childlike faith. You got to talk to God like you was, like you'll talk to a little bitty child talking to a friend. I talk to the Holy Ghost all the time about crazy stuff. What do you think we should eat today? Not me. We won. Amen. So you got to have that relationship with God on that level. It's more than just doing dead works of fasting and praying. That helps become sensitive to God and communicate with God. But, and giving and all that, you don't want to just do dead works. You want to actually get in the presence of God, worship God, talk to him, woo him. Not just when you go to church, not just when you go to conference, not just when you go to meetings, but every day of your life. I talk to God more than I talk to my wife. I talk to God like a wife. I talk to him about my problems. I talk to him about everything. And I be walking down the street talking to God. People think I'm talking to myself. But I am talking to myself because he is in me. I'm his body. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. So I talk to him like I talk to one of y'all. So you gotta do more than just dead works of praying and fasting. You gotta really know God. You gotta hear his voice. You gotta talk to him like you're talking to a person that's sitting right next to you and really visualize him being there. You gotta know the presence of God. That's why in verse 16, it said in Luke chapter 5, verse 16, that Jesus went in the wilderness and prayed. The presence of the Lord didn't come and brought healing virtue until he prayed. But this is the thing. He got in the wilderness. Wilderness is a seclusion place. It's a place of desolence. It's a place to die to self. That's what wilderness represents. If you don't have a place to die to self, a place of desolence, a place where you only talk to God and nobody else, that you're away from the voices of other people, then you will never get the presence of God in your life. Never. If you're a busybody, you're trying to pray but still handle business, you're trying to pray and do this, yeah, ain't nothing wrong with walking and jogging and talking to God, nothing wrong with that. But when you get in a place of seclusion, no children, no spouse, no nothing, you around him by yourself talking to him, that's when you develop the potency of his presence. That's when you develop the potency of his presence. Amen. So you got to know the difference between, and that's the reason why, let me tell you something. I don't have problems. Now hear me when I say that. Everybody has so-called problems or issues. I don't have no problems. Me and my wife don't go through nothing. And even when we go through something, it's nothing. Because simple fact is we don't have problems. Even when family members die, we be like, I try to make myself cry. Because I'm so engulfed in God, it don't even matter to me. This life means nothing to me. If I do buy stuff, it's on a strength of just because of my earthly family. This means nothing to me. I'm dead to this world. I'm a dead man walking, but I'm alive in him. This stuff don't matter to me. I care less about this life. I don't worry about my children that's cutting up. I don't care about this going on and this need to be paid and this one going dealing with this. Because I'm dead to this world. I'm dead to it. I don't care about none of that. You got to work out your own salvation first before you go try to reach others. Get yourself in order first before you try to reach others. God will never give you the nation until the nation and you get in order. God would never give you the nations until the nation and you get in order. Why would God allow you to pollute another nation when your nation is not in order? That's what happened to the United States. We got so polluted and we polluted other countries. Amen? So we got to learn, and I love you, United States of America. I love America. So please, if you're watching, I love my country. Born and raised here in America. Amen. So anyway, The point is this. We have to learn the difference between gifts versus presence. Nothing wrong with gifts. Nothing wrong with gifts. But that's the elementary side. We must graduate to the presence until we develop the spirit of the office of the manifestation. You don't just believe God for a miracle. You become a worker of miracles. You don't believe God for healing. You become a person that moves in the spirit of healing, not just the gifting of healing. You don't just prophesy. You become the office of the prophet, or the spirit of the prophet becomes you. Amen. Even they announced Moses as a deliverer. Oh, goodness. Moses was a deliverer, just like Jesus was. Moses wasn't just working with the deliverer. He became a deliverer. Oh, my God. God said he made him a guard to Pharaoh, and he made Aaron his prophet. So when Moses couldn't finish speaking, his stammering lips spoke to Aaron, and Aaron spoke to the people. But Aaron was always around Moses. He was always in the presence of Moses. That's the reason why God used Aaron as well. That's why he also became a priest. That's why he was over the Levites. Because he stayed in the presence of Moses. They divided Moses' spirit amongst the 70. Not God's spirit, Moses' spirit. Because Moses became not just a person with a gift. He became the gift. He became the gift. He spent so much time in God's presence where his face was shining, to where he came down as like God. And the presence on him was so strong, the people couldn't even contain it. That's how much presence. You got to learn, exactly, you got to learn to graduate in the spiritual realm. From just a person with a gift to the person you become the gift. What are the keys, prophet? Okay, I'm glad you asked. One, you got to develop a personal relationship with God. Two, you got to learn to be a presence seeker. A presence seeker. Three, you got to get under a person who has the presence and has the anointing to release gifts. Paul said Timothy, do not neglect the gift that been prophesied to you by the laying on of the hands of the eldership. But that's people who have presence. Don't neglect the gift that been imparted into you. But remember, it's in part. It's not in whole. It don't become in whole until you walk in the presence. It become whole when you walk in his presence. It become in part when it's a gift. That's why you can neglect it, because it come in seed form. You don't see it. It's like a baby in a womb in 1 month. You don't feel it. You don't see it. You might feel a little something, but you don't recognize it. But when it comes in fullness, when it comes in full presence from spending time, or the baby spending time in you, you can see an outward manifestation of it by the 9th month or by the 6th month. The 4th month, because that baby has spent time in you being nurtured in the gifts and developing itself into the fullness of a person. And then when it comes out, the growth process starts again. So even if you have a gift inside you, until it come out of you, the world won't know about it. And then even after it come out of you, it still gotta grow. Just like a baby. So even if the baby, it grows in you, but there's an outward growing as well. So just because you have an inner gift from the Holy Ghost, you got to have an outward gift, and that needs to even grow. So there's a consistent growing and development of your gift once it come out of you. Just like a baby. A lot of people talking about, I'm birthing a baby out. Okay, you still at birthing. My baby already here and is a teenager, about to be an adult. When you going to get out of the birthing stage and get out into delivering stage and then from delivering stage and let this baby grow. Some of y'all been pregnant for 15 years since y'all been, some of y'all been pregnant with the same baby in the spirit since you've been born again. This year I'm birthing it out. I'm birthing it out this year. When the baby gonna come? And then when the baby gonna grow? If you do got the baby, why the baby still a munchkin? Baby still in diapers. 15-year-old baby. You've been in the spirit for 15 years. You've been saved 20-some years and your baby still in diapers. There's an inner growing and there's an outer growing as well. You got to know how to develop your gifts. Amen? Because when your babies start growing on the outside, then the outside presence start to develop with the baby. That means you can change the weather patterns. People will notice certain things. It will draw all people to your anointing because now the baby is seen. The baby is being seen. The baby is out there. Long pregnancy. Yeah, some people been praying with the same baby, like they're an elephant or something. You know, elephants, you know, take two years or something, they have a baby. You've been praying with that same baby for the long. You done went through about 15 different ministries. 19 different. When the baby gonna be seen? I need to see your baby. When the world gonna know about your baby? Unless the world talk about your baby, you haven't gave birth. Why is somebody drawing mean faces? I'm sorry if I'm making you mad. But anyway, the thing is this. When your baby gonna be seen? Tell me. When is your baby gonna be seen? You've been burning that same prophecy out for the last 15 years. Let that go and start over having a new child. Because apparently that was a miscarriage in the spirit. Apparently it got a... Apparently that baby got stuck in your tube. Apparently you aborted that baby. Because again, in the natural, it only take 9 months for a natural baby to come. Now, one day to us, a thousand years to God is like one. Well, you know the scripture. 1,000 days to us is like one day to God or whatever. So if 1,000 days to us is one day to God, and it takes 9 months for a natural baby to come out, why is your spiritual baby taking so long? Why is your spiritual baby taking so long? If in a natural it only take 9 months, why is your baby taking so long to come out? Natural, I'm going to say this mathematics again. 1,000 years to us is like one day to God. 1,000 years to us is like one day to God. So if that's the case, it takes 9 months for a natural baby to come out. Why your baby taking 9 years? I'm just asking. Because apparently you didn't develop that baby in the presence of God. You didn't spend time with the bridegroom for the birth that baby. You didn't have intimacy time with the husband. You didn't have intimacy time with the husband. You didn't spend time to birth a true birthing out. You heard a person with a gift tell you that you was a prophet. You heard a person with a gift tell you that you was this or tell you that you was that, but you never developed that from the presence of God. And even if that's true, why that has never came out? Why does not the world know about you? Why does not, because when Jesus came out, the world knew about him. When Jesus came out in the power of God, when he birthed his baby out after he got out of the wilderness, the Bible said, and fame went about him in all that region and city. And fame went about him in all that region and city. So that means that when you birth something out, the world going to know about it. Your city going to know about it. Your family going to know about it. The world is going to celebrate that baby. Come on, people. Tell me what's going on. Apparently, you did not birth that baby in the presence of God. You didn't spend time with Jesus to get that baby. You spent time with somebody that told you that you had a baby. You got a misdiagnosis. A misdiagnosis. I'm sorry if my words are slurring. I'm getting tired. But I love you, and I'm here to tell you that we're going to pray for you to go deeper and to get a deeper presence of God so you can birth out a true baby in the spirit and in the natural, if you're believing for that. So because, again, it makes no sense for these things to take so long. Apparently, somebody lied to somebody. Apparently, you got a misdiagnosis, or apparently, you haven't been spending time with the bridegroom for this baby to be conceived. You got to get in his presence. Then you can get the gift. A false positive, exactly. One line on a stick. You need two lines. You need the cross. Not one line on a stick. You need two lines. You need a cross. You need to crisscross it. That's when you know you're pregnant, when you got the cross. Amen? Stop letting people tell you. You're being supposed to birth the business out. You're supposed to been birthed out your ministry. You're supposed to been wrote your book. You're supposed to been did this and that. Everybody been telling you the same thing, misdiagnosis. You need to start all over again. You need to get reprinted. You need to reconceive and reconsider. Reconsider and reconceive. Amen. If you want to go and move in the presence of God, connect with us. Go to my website, inbox me. You want to get in the School of Supernatural, there is a fee. You can be in the School of Supernatural, get around people that's in the presence of God. I will train you in these things. I will train you in the things of God. I will train you how to be a consistent presence holder of his spirit. Sow seed to that anointing. The thing is right there, www.seanmorris.org. Yes, many of us need to start over. Many of us start over. Many of y'all need to start over because y'all been lied to. Y'all been in ministry for 15 years, ain't bust a grape yet. Just go from church to church being pew sitters and you ain't growing. I train leaders. I don't train followers. I train people to be leaders. Start your own ministry. Start this. Do this. Your business, your book, whatever God is telling you to do. That's who I'm called to. So if you want to get in the presence of God, you want to go to a heavy level, you can do it without a mentor. But a mentor, you need to get around people. You know, a man of God said something very powerful one day. And this is powerful. His name is Paul. His name is Apostle Paul. And this is a statement he made. He told Timothy to revisit the faith that was once in your grandmother, I'm paraphrasing, and your mother Lois, your grandmother, you know, Eunice, whatever you want to call it. His anointing or his faith did not come from him seeking alone his own faith. It was through his bloodline. It was through who he was connected to. It was through his family lineage. So some of you are going to receive certain faith. There's some of my spiritual children that only move in certain gifts because they're under me. They ain't start prophesying until they got around me. Or they ain't start moving in gifts. And they ain't saw angel feather, gold dust, money miracle until they got around me. So sometimes, just like Timothy, you got to remember the faith that was once given to your spiritual father, your uncle, your pastor, whoever. Some things, for you to get there quicker, you got to get connected to people who already got it. Because you don't have that discipline already. You don't have that prayer life. You don't have that fasting life yet. There's certain miracles that you won't receive until you connect it to the right person. That once was delivered to the saints. Exactly. So until you connect it to those who once had it, or the ones who have it, it's about who you connected to. So there's certain graces that you will receive that you didn't even have to work for. Just on the strength of you being connected to another leader that has it, you'll operate in it. You'll operate in it. You'll begin to operate in the miracles. You'll begin to operate in the signs, the wonders. Many of my spiritual children, they move in healing. They move in signs and wonders, miracles. And they spiritual children move in miracles, healings, and stuff like that. But a lot of that, they didn't work for. A lot of that grace that they have on their life, they did not work for. They just got connected and got in covenant with those who went before them. And now that grace is on their life. So if you think you don't need a man, you sadly mistake. It's going to take you longer. It's going to take you much, much longer if you try to do it on your own. Without the help of man, it's going to take much longer. So certain faith that you're going to move in, not just regular faith, but supernatural faith that other people have moved in, you ain't going to be able to move in it until you get connected to those who had it. Some people are receiving miracles just on the strength of my faith, strength of my prayer life, and me and my wife. They move in a grace and a glory that they didn't work for. Even people that come to our meetings. As a matter of fact, at the Supernatural Sisters Conference, I lay hands on people who never prophesied before. They begin to prophesy. Never moved in word of knowledge, never called out names before, never did none of that before until I lay hands on them, until I released that glory of prophecy over them. But they wasn't moving off their own anointing. Because I guarantee you, if you try to go get them to prophesy right now, they won't be able to do it. But they were moving off of the grace that was on my life. So you got to get connected with those who are already operating in the faith. Connect with those who have the faith already, who already have the presence. So all you got to do is just come up under that umbrella and you will receive. I know y'all don't like to hear that. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. But I just wanted to say that there's a difference between gifts and presence. Please share this video. People need to hear this. They might not like this message, but it's much needed. Please share this with your friends. Share this with your loved ones. Share this all over. Make it go viral. Because simple fact is, we got to know the difference between, yes, inheritance through honor. Exactly, Apostle Blair. A lot of people, if you want to receive anointing quicker and faster, do it through honor. Do it through discipleship. Do it through sowing. Not just fasting and praying on your own, because you might fast and pray and pick up a demonic spirit if you're not careful. Remember, people in the other world, in the underworld, they fast and pray too. So unless you go into a realm that you don't know about, if you don't have a spiritual mentor or spiritual leader that can tell you and identify with that realm, you'll go there and look and lost. So seeking on your own is not enough. You still need guidance from other people. No, we're not here to make friends at all. Prophets are very direct and blunt people. If you want looking for a pastor, you got the wrong guy. Pastors pacify. I don't pacify. That's not me. So if you find a prophet that's not straightforward or straight direct, 9 times out of 10, he ain't a real prophet. Yeah, even Jezebel fasted. Exactly. So just because you fasted and praying, if you don't understand the right realm, you're going to a wrong realm. So that's why you need a person to guide you in the things of the spirit. So when you do walk into something, you won't walk in loss. You know, ask, seek, and knock. But even when you knock, you don't have the key. Somebody on the other side got to open the door for you. Somebody on the other side got to open the door for you. So you don't have the key. Even when you knock, the door shall be open. Why you had to knock if you had the keys? Somebody else have the keys to open the door for you. So even if you knock, even if you seek, you found it, but you found it, you don't know what to do with it. So you start knocking for it to open up to you. And when you knock, the door shall be open because somebody's on the other side with the key to unlock it. You still need a man or woman of God to unlock it. Not saying that you can't seek the Lord on your own. I'm not taking away from your personal prayer life. I urge everybody to have a personal prayer life and personal relationship with God. But even then, you're still going to have to connect with other people who are connected for you to walk through certain doors. There's the realm of God, and then there's the realm of man. And while you're in the earth realm, you still got to go through the realm of man. Even if you are in all good with God. But that's another teaching. Y'all can see that on my YouTubes. About the realm of God versus the realm of man. But anyway, the point is I'm trying to make is know the difference between gift and presence. And get with those who have the presence and the faith for the presence. There's a difference between having faith and having the spirit of faith. There's a difference between having the gift and having the presence. Amen. So make sure you understand the difference. Having the office and having the presence. Because see, this is another thing. There may be people who have an office and don't have a presence. I know a lot of apostles and prophets that have an office but still don't have a presence. It's a big difference. You got to know the difference, people of God. That will determine what will remain. That will determine what will manifest quicker. That will determine who, you know, what's the difference. Amen? Amen? So just because they can see it don't mean that they can unlock it. Just because they can get a message from heaven don't mean that they can get a manifestation from heaven. I know a lot of people like, I hear from God for myself, but still broke. I hear from God for myself, but still don't prophesy. I hear from God for myself, but still don't do certain things. Yeah, too many title grabbers today. They got a badge with no gun. Flashlight cops in the spirit. Amen. Can't lock up nothing. They can't buy nothing. They can't unlock nothing. They can't lock nobody up, and they can't unlock for somebody. You know, they got a flashlight. Yeah, you gotta have the fruits. You gotta have, you can't have just have a badge with no gun. Many people got a title. I'm a prophet. I'm an apostle. I'm like, oh, really? Like, oh, really? you're a prophet, huh? Prophesy. You're an apostle? Okay, manifest. Amen. Show me something. I'll hold your Bible after that. Amen. Praise the Lord. But we cannot be title seekers. We got to really be presence seekers. And in the midst of being presence seekers, God will give us our entitlements. He'll give us our badges of honor. Amen. He'll give us our badges of honor. And don't even seek the power. Seek the training of knowing the office, the officer of the office, and the office giver. Know those realms. And then God will give you the badge and he'll give you the gun so you have the power with the badge. He'll give you the cuffs, the keys to lock and unlock. To bind and loose for those who didn't know what I was saying. To bind means to arrest and to loose means to set free. Amen. That's why Jesus said, I came to set the captives free. Amen. He knows about the jailer. You know, he can loose you or he can lock you up. Yeah, this is why people must be exactly in the right way. If you don't be processed in the right way, what will happen is you will eventually get an illegal license in the spirit. And you will think you have a license to carry, but all the while you have a license to bury yourself. You got to know the difference. You got to know what's legal in the spirit and what's illegal. And that's why the sons of Sceva, they had the name of Jesus. They knew this and that, but they were moving out of illegal license. You know, Paul, we know his license. Jesus, we know his credentials. But who are you? Just because you try to practice something on your own. And see, this goes back to mentorship. Just because you say in the name of Jesus, just because you thought you had a relationship with God, you thought you had one, you'll end up having an illegal license to try to enter into a spiritual realm that you know nothing about. This is why you gotta have no Paul. You gotta have a Paul in your life. Paul said, imitate me as I imitate Christ. See, that's why he made the difference between, he said, yeah, Paul, we know. Jesus, we know, but who are you? Because there was a protocol between the two. Paul followed Christ and his disciples followed him. Amen. So if without following that certain man of God, I don't care how much you think you know God, the demons will even let you know that you're illegal. Paul, we know. Jesus, we know. But who are you? You didn't come through the legal way. You didn't come with legal documentations of who you really are. Did y'all see that flash before me? Did y'all see that orb flash before me? Anyway, you have legal documentation of God. And that's the reason why they got beat up in the spirit. You cannot enter a spiritual realm, even trying to enter in the presence of God, illegally. But that's another teaching, and we're not going to get into that. But the thing is, people of God, you saw it, huh, man of God? It flew across my face. I just saw another one just now. See, that's the difference. See, presence. We sit up here, and I see orbs flying across my face. Amen. When you talk on these subjects about the glory begin to manifest. So, you know, exactly. That's a sign to let you know what we're saying is the truth. You know, he confirmed his word with signs following. Flashes of light, exactly. Amen. But be careful even with angels of light. You got to discern that too. Amen. If they ain't preaching the message of Jesus Christ, if they ain't preaching the gospel, be careful of that too. But I know these are legit ones. They're all around. Amen. Praise God. So again, know the difference between the gift versus the presence. Please share this with everybody you know. Go to www.showmore.org. Sow into that anointing. We're going to Africa. Sow into that glory. That same anointing and presence is going to be upon you. I believe we're going to do a conference in Houston at the end of March. This in a couple of weeks. So be praying. Amen. Amen. So make sure y'all be praying for us for going to Africa. We're going to Word Network in May, and we're going to some other television shows in May. Can't tell y'all about the other ones, but y'all see us on TV. And make sure you support, buy the books. The book is coming out in June, but they're going to have an early release for it in May. The name of the book is called How to Tap into the Glory of God. It's a must read. Is a revamped version of my old book called Tap, but this is a bigger version. Destiny Image is published by Destiny Image, and it's a powerful book. Make sure you get it when you see us on Sid Roth. Make sure you get it when you see us on the Word Network. I want y'all to buy it out. Amen. Buy it out. People keep seeing, y'all keep seeing them orbs. Hallelujah. Praise God. So make sure you go to www.showmore.org. And make sure you get the books. And Prayer with Prophetess Thursday. Prophet, you come in and tell them people. Come here. No, come here. See, she acting like she in the gift right now. She ain't acting in the presence. She acting like somebody with a gift to the person with a presence. Tell them.
Blessings, blessings, blessings. Yes, Prayer with Prophetess on Thursday at 7:00, Facebook Live. I will be praying for people and prophesying to you guys.
Prophesying.
Going deep, deep, deep.
Amen. And I won't be on it, so she won't get me to, because y'all got to pay me $1 million for me to prophesy to y'all. I'm just joking. Just only $500,000. Praise the Lord. But anyway, I love y'all. We bless y'all. I thank God for y'all. Again, replay this again. Put this on your wall. Share, share, share if you really care. You're lighter and you can see the glory on your face. Amen. I receive
glory.
I look like Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I feel the Lord upon me. Hallelujah.
I feel the prayer coming. You need to pray for the people, honey.
I should pray for y'all before
pray
I end,
for
huh?
The people. Yeah, pray for the people.
Huh, I don't pray that much. Hallelujah. Oh, Roshi the Bomo Roshi, me, mama, baba, rabaha, shoulda, bomo, mo. Amen, mama, baba, rasho, me, rebe, Lord, I release a prophetic glory over this atmosphere. I pray that people be healed, set free, and delivered. In the name of Jesus, I pray that money miracles begin to manifest right now. I command y'all to hold up your wallets right now, your purses. Get your wallets, get your purse. God is about to do a miracle. And when he do that miracle, you're going to know that God did it. It's going to multiply your bank accounts. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your bank accounts, your credit, everything is about to, it's about to spuse right now. It's about to boost right now. I command in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Ghost, that bank accounts right now, let money miracles manifest and multiply. Multiplication round begin to take place right now.
Yes.
I command in the name of Jesus, the angels of money miracles be released.
Yes.
In your bank accounts, wallets, purses, right now, in the name of Jesus, release that glory right now, in the name of Jesus. Multiplication take place right now. Like, Lord, I declare and decree thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of dollars begin to manifest out of nowhere, from the north, the south, east, and the west. Lord, unexpected checks in the mail, jobs calling by tomorrow. By this time tomorrow, jobs will begin to call and say that you are hired. In the name of Jesus, you will start Monday. Many of you are going to start jobs Monday. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare and decree that many of you are going to walk in the power of God, the healing virtue of God, the deliverance anointing of God, and the glory of God. I speak it right now. Receive it, fire, in the name of Jesus. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive it in the name of Jesus. By this time tomorrow, your whole life gonna change. Your people are gonna be delivered. You're gonna have testimonies. I wanna see testimonies. I want you to post testimonies, inbox us with the testimonies from tonight in the name of Jesus. Money will appear in your bank accounts. Money will appear in your pockets. Some of you begin to check right now. Begin to check right now. As you're checking right now, you're gonna see a difference. I don't care if it's $20. $2, $200, $2,000, whatever. You're going to see a difference from what you did had and what you didn't have.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. Instant weight loss right now. In the name of Jesus, be released.
Jesus' name. Woo!
Check. Begin to check. Begin to check. Begin to check. I want you to tell your testimony. Begin to check
pain
your wallet.
Pain leaving your body right now.
Pain leave your body. Providence, you say that.
Pain leaving your body right now in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, I see somebody right now that's been having neck pain, like a crook in your neck, goes now in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. That's being healed right now in the name of Jesus. Whistling in the ears is being healed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we release the fire of God right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for those that want to see in the spirit, Lord, that they want to see in the spirit more. In the name of Jesus, put your hands on your eyes. Put your hands on your eyes. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I remove the scales from their eyes right now in the name of Jesus. And let the fire of the Holy Ghost touch right now in Jesus' name. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost touch right now in the name of Jesus. Receive the fire of God. The fire of God. The fire of God. The fire of God be released in your life. The fire of God be in your belly. The fire of God be in your hand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Check. I see money falling. Check. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Check
your pockets.
I feel the fire of God.
Check your bank
accounts. The fire of God.
Woo! Check your body. pain has left. Lumps dissolve. Cancer die. In the name of Jesus. Sister Paula. Paula, I don't know if you're there. Paula. The pain is gone. My neck was in pain today. Pain is gone.
My God.
Hallelujah. Sister Jesus. Paula. I don't know. I saw Paula. Sister Paula. I seen a church. I seen a church with your name on it. I seen Paula. A church connected to you. And I seen it in a storefront. A storefront facility. And I seen people getting healed and get out of wheelchairs. And you collecting wheelchairs and canes from the people.
Go deep.
Sister Paula. Sister Paula. Hallelujah. If you're there, Sister Paula. I ain't come here to prophesy. I just had this word for Paula. Shadabai Mirishu.
Paula Jean.
Paula Jean. I seen a storefront. Confirm if that's. I seen a storefront and I seen a church and I seen that you had wheelchairs and canes. You was collecting them from people getting healed.
Hallelujah.
In a service. I seen a branch in almost looked like Las Vegas and I seen one in California.
Jesus said glory.
Hallelujah. I seen a branch in California. And I seen a branch almost like in Las Vegas. And God is going to allow it to come. He said, locate me, Father. LOL.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Ooh, I feel the anointing right now.
Glory. Paula. It's going to be in California. And it's going to be in Las Vegas. I don't know if in any of those states mean anything to you. Las Vegas. She said yes.
Hallelujah.
What does that mean to you? Las Vegas or California? Yes. Hallelujah. Las Vegas or in California? She said yes.
Hallelujah.
So Las Vegas and California, you know those states.
Yes.
Amen. Apostle Blair.
He just tapped.
I felt
that too. That's why I said, when he said that, I said, woof, I feel that.
Oh, you working on both now? On glory. Both cities? California and Las Vegas. Can I prophesy?
Prophesy.
So you working on California and Las Vegas. Hallelujah. Look at God. She said, I'm working on both right now. Hallelujah. But I seen in these two locations, I seen that people were getting healed. And I seen a bunch of people with wheelchairs and people with cane. Because there's an anointing. She said, yes. There's an anointing for you for the healed people with cancers. She said, Mama, you can locate me too. Hallelujah. But I seen Las Vegas and California. I seen you traveling back and forth, establishing these places. And I also seen you setting people in place.
Hallelujah.
I also seen that there were people with canes and in these wheelchairs and people getting healed because you had dealt with that before yourself. And God, oh, you saw that orb just now?
Yeah.
And God is going to use you in that. Now, I know about your cane situation, but God was showing me about that situation that God is going to use you in a powerful way in that realm. Amen. And that many people are going to be healed through your ministry. She said, my God, many people are going to be healed through your ministry.
Jesus.
She said, yes.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And God has given you anointing to heal people from cancer as well. Cancer. This goes to Paula. Something dealing with people with cancer. And as soon as you pray for them, they will be healed. They will be healed by the power of God. Because I saw Las Vegas and I saw California and I saw people with cancer being healed as well as you pray for them. Amen. So let the Lord use you powerfully, woman of God. And I can't wait to come to those locations in Jesus' name. Because God showed me those locations, California.
Hallelujah.
And also Las Vegas, Nevada. Amen. Even people in the gaming industry, they're doing a lot of casinos and things like that. I seen them coming as well, getting saved, set free, and delivered. And hallelujah. Everything is already being funded. Because I see like money being given to you, almost like a lawsuit. But it's some money that's owed to you. And I seen some money
prophesied.
Being given to you.
Prophesied.
I don't know if it's an accident. I don't know what something happened. I don't know if it's an accident or something. But some type of inheritance money is supposed to be given to you.
Prophesied.
Hallelujah. Indianapolis, India as well.
Amen.
I seen some money being given to you. Something like, I don't know, some court releasing some money to you or whatever, a settlement or something. But yes, I seen Lord. Some money coming to you from a situation. So I don't know what that means, but I seen that it was some money being released to you and that you're going to use a lot of this stuff to fund the gospel and a lot of stuff. Because I seen a lot of properties and you purchasing a lot of properties as well as the Lord begin to use you. In the things of the spirit. So just go with the Lord and let the Lord use you in a powerful way. Amen. And when you get rich, 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 don't forget about your peoples. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That goes out for Sister Paula. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Can you say something for Apostle Blair?
Apostle Blair. Apostle Lionel Blair. I just want to tell you, man of God, this is a word. Again, we just doing small, small. I'm not prophesying deep, deep. Y'all got to come to the meeting for that. But we just doing small, small right now for y'all. Because y'all been on here with me this long. But Apostle Blair, God is going to use you powerfully, like I told you before, in the East Coast areas. But I even see a migration also even with you in the South as well. We love you much too, Sister Paula. You're going to be just traveling all across the world. Your book is going to sell. I believe prophets have a stronger word for you.
Apostle Blair, I see contracts is coming to you. Something pertaining to contracts. I remember when I told prophet, I seen the same thing like you. I remember when I told you, I seen a Caucasian man giving you a contract and you were signing it.
Right.
And it was for your book deal.
Yeah, and as soon as she said that, that's when I got the book deal with Destiny Image.
And I see the same contract. I didn't know what it was. I don't know if it was book or what, but I don't know. I see this same Caucasian man, and I see that you're signing a contract, and it's a long paper, and it's a contract that you're going to sign, but it's going to bring you money. This contract is going to bring you money. And that's what I'm seeing, a contract that I see a contract, and I see the Caucasian man. He's handing it to you, and I see you signing it. That's what I'm seeing.
And we're going to believe God for that because guess what? You get paid, that's more tithes and offerings for me. Praise the Lord.
Come on now.
In Jesus' name. And you know what the thing is, man of God, Apostle, I want to tell you this. There's going to be so much glory on you in this season.
Come on now.
To where people are going to seek you out to come to their churches because of the glory of the Lord that's going to be upon your life. And I'm speaking this as a declaration. Yeah, my phone was dying. That devil didn't want me to prophesy to him. Because I was feeling the unction to function.
Is it possible? Back on.
Hallelujah. That devil got mad. Praise the Lord. Yeah, that was my phone, Apostle. That was all on me. That was my phone went out because it was on 1%. I didn't even know it was unplugged. But there's a glory of God that's going to be upon you very heavy in this season to where people are going to seek you out for the presence of God. And the glory, and mainly, and see, the subject that I was talking about tonight, a lot, you know, you You already move in the presence, but the presence is about to excel even in a higher dimension with you.
Come on now.
People, just by your shadow, is going to be healing the sick. Many people are going to be touched by the power of God.
Yes.
And there's going to be an apostolic assembly that you're going to bring together in the United States. People are going to come from all over the country. You're going to work with other apostles and train them in the apostolic and how to do it in a powerful way. Many things you already know. But what I'm seeing also is that you're going to move in a higher dimension of glory than most apostles ever walked in. You're going to walk in biblical glory. You're going to walk. There's a difference between this, the glory that's going on now versus biblical glory. Hallelujah. It is so to you. This is a prophetic fact. This is not just a prophetic word. This is a prophetic fact, and this is going to happen to you not even in the days to come. You're going to be moving in the glory,
Jesus.
And that the power of God for revival and renewal and restructuring is going to take place. Because, see, the kingdom of God comes also with the presence of God, his power, his glory, and his structure. And you're going to operate in that in a higher dimension than most people never walked in. You're going to even see miracles that people never seen before, even walking on water. So get ready to be moving in the glory of God so powerful that nobody will be able to withstand the glory that's going to be upon your life. You and your wife are going to train people in this glory manifestation. Because the apostolic doctrine is the presence of God. The apostolic manifestations is the presence of the Father in the whole entirety of his kingdom. And you're going to move in it in a powerful way, thus said the Lord. And I speak it right now. And as I'm speaking it, you're already beginning to receive the seed of implantation of his spirit in a powerful way. And it's growing at a great measure. And nothing will be able to stop you, come before you. And nobody will be able to touch the anointing upon your life. They may speak, but it's going to be so powerful that they're going to think it's demonic. It's going to be so unheard of today, going to think it's demonic. That's how powerful it's going to be. Because most religious people, most church people, anything they don't understand that it is powerful and supernatural, the first thing they scream out is demonic. But that's how powerful the anointing is going to be upon your life. The same wells that was upon John G. Lake, you're going to reopen those wells for healing. I see healing schools with you and prophet. I just seen it just now with you and Apostle Jasmine. The wells of John G. Lake is going to open up to you, and the healing grace and the healing anointing for that anointing is going to be upon you. And they're going to be house churches that you're going to train people. Forget the buildings. There are going to be many house churches that you're going to be training people, and people are going to be coming to you for apostolic training and training in these healing homes. They're going to be like healing homes, and people are going to be having a lot of stuff in not just building but healing homes, and they're going to be coming to you for you to come and tutor them and train them in the healing of God.
Come on now.
Thus said the Lord. It is already done. You're going to move in that power, and many people are not going to be able to understand the grace and the anointing upon your life. There's going to be another Ebola breakout, and when you pray for people who have Ebola, they will be healed instantly.
Come on now.
Watch when it comes to pass.
Grace of fasting is coming upon y'all.
Yes. The grace of fasting
is coming upon y'all.
They're going to be an incurable disease that's going to hit. And you and Apostle Jasmine are going to be praying for people who had that incurable disease.
Jesus.
And people are going to be getting healed. And that's how the news is going to know about y'all. That's how people are going to know about y'all ministry in a powerful way. And it's going to spread like wildfire. Woo. When it happens, you're going to say, that man of God, my spiritual father, is a true prophet of God.
Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
And watch it come to pass. Watch it come to pass. Watch it come to pass. I'm talking about incurable diseases. Incurable diseases. Incurable diseases. I'm talking about major diseases. We're just doing small right now. It is done. Mark my word. That's not no encouragement. That is a prophetic fact. Mark my word. It's going to manifest in a powerful way. God is going to use you in a powerful way. LaShawn, I see designs all around you. I seen designs all around you. I hear angelic voices singing all around you.
Hallelujah.
I seen artistry all around you. I seen like a record player all around you. God is going to do some powerful things in your life, woman of God. I don't know what that means to you, but I seen like a record player all around you. I hear singing, and I saw a bunch of clothes and designs all around you and artistry all around you. LaShawn Givens, I'm speaking to you. I seen like a record player all around you, and God is using you in a powerful way, woman of God. And everything that you're believing for in this season is about to come to pass.
Hallelujah.
And guess what? You will move in the prophetic in a heavy way, because Hallelujah. That's one of the anointings that you're believing God for, and God is going to use you in a powerful way. So God is saying that you're going to open up the prophetic realm to you in this season. Oh, y'all keep seeing it, but I seen the record player. I seen the record player. I seen music all around you, and I seen designs all around you. I don't know what that means to you, but like I seen clothes that you were designing. I seen almost like a boutique type situation going on. Please confirm what I'm saying so the people can know that I ain't just speaking amiss. Please confirm, say yes, that's what I do or something. But I seen it all around you, and I also seen the prophetic gift that's flowing all around. She said, yes, I feel the glory of the Lord. Amen.
Come on now.
But I seen that a prophetic anointing is being released upon you, and in this season you shall see like never before, and you shall speak and prophesy like never before. Yes, I've been led to sing. Exactly. Because God is going to use you. I seen music all around you. I seen a record player all around you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I seen that God is going to use you powerfully. You're going to cut a CD, and people are going to be getting healed while you be singing. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And you're going to prophesy and sing prophetically to the people. Amen.
Jesus.
So get ready to cut your own CD, because I seen a record player. I seen angels singing all around. I don't know you from Adam. She said, you are real.
Come on now.
I don't know you from Adam, but I'm telling you what the Lord is saying, and I seen it all around you, and I also seen designer clothes all around you, and I seen shops with stuff, with clothes and stuff like that around you, and a lot of people, I seen you doing like, these people doing this fashion model type stuff going on.
Come on now.
And you was like over it, and these women were modeling clothes and doing fashion type stuff all around. I don't know what that means to you. I don't know if it's something in the near future that you're going to do or something that you thought of, but I seen people doing it, plus with the music stuff and the prophetic gift. Please confirm what I'm saying, woman of God. But I seen it all around you, and I seen when you do this CD, that the power of God is going to be so resonated on it that many people are going to be getting healed and set free as you sing prophetically.
Come on now.
Amen. Please confirm what I'm saying, woman of God. Hallelujah. I don't know if she's still there. Please respond so I can keep flowing. Praise the Lord. The more we respond, the more the Lord begin to speak. I don't know her from Adam, but she said, I sing. Yes, man of God, I thought of my own clothing line. Praise the Lord. See, God is speaking prophetically. See, I saw you having your own clothing line. I told you, I saw you have the boutique, and I saw people modeling these clothes. Amen. See, you had the thought, but God had the answer. Amen. You had the thought for it. See, when you have the thought, he already gave you the answer. When you have a thought for something, it's not just you thinking it. It's God implanting vision in you.
So that
clothing line is going to come to fruition, because I saw the clothes. I saw the women modeling the clothes. I saw the boutique. I saw you singing. Just like I saw you singing and I saw the clothes, God is just not giving that to you. Hallelujah. Yes, he don't know me. He is speaking. Amen. Yes, yes. I'm doing small prophecy right now. Like I said, I don't know you from Adam. I don't know nothing about you. This is my first time really seeing you on my Facebook Live. But that's what God was showing me, woman
Hallelujah.
Of God. And he's going to use that in a powerful way. And also, you're going to also prophesy, woman of God. Amen. Because I see that as you begin to do stuff, you have influence over a lot of people. A lot of people follow you. So God is using you as a leader in this season to do great things. And just know that God is going to use you for his glory and not man's glory. Amen. So just know that the Lord is going to use those two main giftings to use you to bring upon a glory in your city. Amen. I don't know you from Adam, but I seen you even traveling I seen you even going to California, but I seen Florida in your midst, and I seen Virginia in your midst. Amen. I seen Florida in your midst, and I seen Virginia in your midst, and I seen people in Atlanta saying, come over here, we'll give you a deal. I seen people in Atlanta say, come over here, we'll give you a deal. Come over here, we'll give you a deal. Come on, I don't know what that means to you. I don't know what that city means to you. But I seen people in Atlanta saying, come over here, we'll give you a deal. But I seen Florida, and I also seen Virginia. Amen, that you're going to be traveling in these different locations. Hallelujah. Yes, I do have a lot of followers, and he's been teaching me to lead as of now. Amen. Because I see that you have a lot of Florida has been in my spirit. Amen. Praise God. And God is saying that he's going to use you in these areas to bless the people of God, because you have leadership skill and you can lead many women. You can lead many people, period. Even men respect who you are. They respect your. Hey, my partner is in Atlanta. Hey, come on, can I prophesy? I saw people in Atlanta telling you that you come over here. We got a deal for you. So you have a partner in Atlanta. You say you feel a spirit in Florida. And God is going to use these places for you to do great things in him. Like I said, I don't know you from Adam, but you're going to do great things. And God is going to give you a prophetic mentor that's going to teach you in the prophetic and for you to go to another level in the spiritual realm. Thus said the Lord of hosts for your life, woman of God. Amen.
Her eyes are burning. See, because God is
she said her eyes are burning. Hallelujah.
Your eyes are opening up to see
God is opening some of your eyes right now in the spiritual realm as my wife began to pray for the seer's realm. Amen. Yeah, this is small prophecy. We're going to get even in more details. But if you want to get in the school of the supernatural woman of God, inbox me. If you already have a covering, stick with your covering. But you're going to need a prophetic mentor to teach you in the things of the prophetic and help launch that vision of that prophetic anointing, and also to launch in that prophecy. Amen. So there's a difference between the gift versus just the presence. See, I'm talking in the presence. So that means that in the presence, the future going to become now.
Come on now.
The future is going to become now. Amen. Blessing, my eyes have been burning. Oh, Lord. No, don't worry about it. It's a good thing, because that is the seer's anointing being opened up to you. God is opening up your eyes
to see
in the spiritual realm. Just like my wife said, she released the seer's anointing. We release that prophetic anointing over your life, because that's why I said you're gonna begin to move in the gift of prophecies. Those who are eyes are burning, that lets you know that you're called towards that gifting. Okay, I will look into the supernatural. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. But again, you don't have to be attached to us. Whoever God leads you to help open up that gift, stick with that person, serve, sow, and submit, and watch all those things that I just spoken come to pass. So start working on your material, getting your stuff for your clothing line. Because again, I don't know you from Adam, but God knows who you are. And so you know that today that God spoke through you to you from a prophet. Amen. So make sure. She said, yes, I've been seeing things in the spirit. Amen. Amen. Praise God. So that lets you know what you're called to. So now you just got to get connected with somebody who flows in it and unlocks it even to a higher level. Amen. Praise God. So again, I don't know you from Adam, but I'm glad that God allowed you to come on today and for me to speak into your life, my wife to speak into your life. Amen. God spoke. I see and hear things that others can't. Exactly. Because you are called to the prophetic. Oh, I don't just say that over anybody. Amen. Prophets recognize prophets. Seers recognize seers. Hearers recognize hearers. Amen. I don't just say that over everybody's life, because everybody don't have that gifting. Amen. But God has given you that gifting. Amen. Kim said, LaShawn, me too. Amen. Amen, Kim. Praise God. You too. Amen. Thank you. Love you, man and woman of God. Amen. Blessings to you, woman of God. Amen. Take that word to the bank. Amen. God, everything God spoke, take it to the bank. It's already done. Amen. So now what you do as the recipient, like I taught earlier, what you go do is you go walk for that prophecy to come to pass. Start making steps toward that prophecy, and also begin to get in his presence so God can begin to allow that to come to fruition. Amen. Amen. Praise God. So, you know, amen, woman of God. Amen. And stay connected with us. Amen. And I don't know where you're at. I don't know where your church at. I don't know where you live. But just stay connected with us on Facebook. And, you know, hopefully in the near future you can come to one of our meetings, or we come to your church, or whatever the case may be. Amen. Praise God. But, Prophet, do you have a word for somebody?
No. Nothing else.
Amen. Praise God. Well, we did a little small today. Praise God. Y'all need to catch me in this. Come to the meetings where we go deeper.
Deep.
Come to the meetings where we go a little more deeper. Amen. So make sure y'all stay connected again. If you'd like to sow a seed to the ministry in Chicago, amen. Chi-Town.
Come on now.
Rashodobo. 98 in Bishop. Chicago in the building. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Make sure you stay connected to us, woman of God. Send friend requests or send whatever. And be our friend. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But we about to close because I got to get up in here and do some stuff. And I got to get ready for some other stuff. I got to do a lot of stuff. Yeah, go to www.showmore.org. If you receive a word from the God, sow on that word. Again, if you didn't receive a word from God, still sow anyway. Sow into the anointing. Sow where you're trying to go. If you have a prophetic gift, sow into that anointing. www.showmore.org. Let the Lord lead you on what to sow into. Again, it's not about receiving money for prophecy or anything like that. Just sow where you're trying to go. Amen. If you want that anointing, sow into it. Amen. You want the gift in the excel, sow into it. Amen. Hallelujah. My roshudobo. But we love y'all. I release the grace of God upon your life. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and yes, be gracious Lord. To you. May the Lord lift up his countenance towards you. And may the Lord give you his children his shalom peace. Again, we're going to be having a meeting maybe at the end of March in Houston. But the biggest meeting in Houston is May 5th through 7th with Prophetess Valerie Moore. She moves accurate in the prophecy. She's my sister. She go deeper and reach for her beeper.
Yes.
Make sure you come May 5th through 7th, Houston, Texas.
Don't miss
this one-on-one with the prophets. I don't care if you're in Chicago, Virginia, wherever, LA, whatever. You need to come to these conferences. No other conference be like these conferences. I mean, people be leaving out different.
Come on now.
Come to these conferences. May the 5th through 7th, Prophetess Valerie Moore is going to be at 6300 West Park Drive, Houston, Texas, zip code 77057, suit 310 at the Rock Worship Center. Make sure you come. It's free. You don't have to pay no fee. It's free. You don't have to pay
free.
Free. And when you come, you will get free.
Men are invited.
It's a prophetic conference, so it's not a women's conference.
Yeah.
It's one-on-one with the prophets. We're going to be bringing out prophets from all over the world, from Africa, wherever. Well, whoever anointed prophet we know that we're in covenant with, we're bringing them out. So if you want impartation in the prophetic, you want to go higher in the prophetic, or you just need a word from God, make sure you come to the conferences. I want to see all my spiritual children there, all the ones that are out of town. Hoseland, I want to see you there. LaBanca, I want to see you there. Apostle Blair, Jasmine, whatever, y'all need to come there too. I need everybody to come to this conference and be
y'all.
A part of what God is doing. Amen.
Yes.
Make sure y'all come. Invite your friends. Share the flyer. I'm going to be posting up the flyer under this video and the other video. Make sure you come. Don't miss it. I am Apostle Prophet Sean Morris. I love you. Me and Prophetess love you.
Love you.
We bless you, and we are out.